Hey, good morning to you. Hey, Jesus is Lord. Thank God. Thank God Jesus is Lord. And the word works. You have to work it a little bit, but it works. The power is in the seed of the word of God. You, the believer, sow the seed into your heart. That seed will grow up and it will produce in your life and it will finally prevail over every area of your life. Romans chapter 10, people say, well, without faith, it's impossible to please God. How do I get it? Only one way. Over in Romans chapter 10, it says here, verse 8, but what saith it? The word is nigh thee. That's near, very close to you. The word is nigh thee. Now watch this. The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart, that is the word of faith which we preach. So this is all about faith, the word of faith which we preach, that if thou shalt confess, say what the word says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in your heart. Now, there's two parts here that I want you to see. You have to believe it in your heart. But the way you believe it in your heart is by saying it with your mouth. Because the more you hear it, the stronger it gets. Now, then we're going to skip a few verses here. So the word is nigh thee, it's in your heart so that you can say it. I mean, it's in your mouth so that you can say it. It's in your heart so that you can believe it. Now, watch what it says over here in verse 17. I mean, you've heard this and heard it and heard it. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So then faith cometh. That's some big words there. Faith. Somebody said, well, I need faith. I wish I had the faith that Brother So-and-so had, or I wish I had faith to move that mountain. Well, you do, but you're going to have to hear the word for your faith to grow and for you to have it. So then, faith cometh. Notice the word cometh there. I want to deal with that one for just a minute or two here. Faith cometh by hearing, which is a present tense thing that you have to do. Faith does not come by having heard. Now, I've made this mistake, and probably you have too, back 20 years ago, 30 years ago, when everybody was teaching faith. Boy, we'd go to those meetings and plant that seed of the Word of God, and faith would come. Faith would be high at a meeting because everybody was hearing the Word. And we'd see miracles at the meeting, and we'd have miracles a week or two after because faith cometh. But now, 20 years later, faith still cometh. And it cometh by presently hearing the Word of God. What you got to do is go plant the seed of the Word of God. Well, I don't want to plant the seed of the Word of God. I'm tired of it. Listen, I've had some situations where I knew I needed to plant the seed of the Word of God, but I didn't want to. Didn't change the situation. The only way I'm going to change the situation is by planting the seed of the Word of God. Sometimes I'd rather go ride my motorcycle or as we used to say as boys, go outside and play. But if I'm going to receive from God, I've got to plant the seed of the Word of God. Now, watch this. A farmer can't hope to have a crop if he's not going to get out there and plant the seed. Well, you can't hope to have a crop of healing unless you're planting the seed of the Word of God rather than sitting around hoping and griping and complaining and saying, well, I wish I had a crop. No, plant the seed. A little work involved there, but you're going to have to do that. Faith cometh. Cometh by hearing. Somebody says, well, I know that faith comes by trials. No, trials comes to kill you. Satan comes to steal, kill, and destroy. He doesn't come to build your faith. Somebody says, well, I went through a trial. Boy, my faith got strong. Let me tell you what happened. You went through a trial, and because you're going through a trial, you decided, I'm going to go to the Word and find out what's going on here. So you begin to search the Word. You begin to talk the Word. You begin to hear the Word and let the Word grow up in your heart. And faith came. See, it wasn't the trial that brought it. It was what you was doing to try to get out of it. It caused the Word to grow as you were planting the seed of the Word of God. Faith doesn't come by going through a trial. And faith doesn't come by seeing a miracle, even if it's yours. Faith doesn't come that way. Faith cometh by hearing. Only way it comes. I wish that I could tell you that there was another way, but there's not. Word's true. So let me read it again. So then faith. Faith in God. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. The more you read it, the more you speak it, the more it comes, the more you have, and you can get out of that situation in Jesus' name. Nothing is impossible to him that believes. You can change it, but you're going to have to change it with the word, and that's the only way that your faith is going to come. It's not going to come by crying and begging and pleading, saying, "Oh, God, don't you see I'm having a trial? Don't you know I'm sick?" Yeah, he knows that. But you're going to have to go and find out what Jesus has already done and start saying what the word says and say, "With his stripes I was healed, and himself bore my sicknesses and carried my diseases. And with his stripes, I'm going to get up out of this mess and go on about your way." Hey, it's another beautiful day here. Weekend of vacation time. Enjoy it. But enjoy the word. And remember, that's the only way that faith comes. So, hey, until I'm with you tomorrow, saints, have a great day. And remember, faith comes by hearing the word. Jesus is Lord. Thank God the word works.